Okay, this is the second annual Poetry Polar Bear Swim. It's a little bit colder this year. It's a little bit colder. There's ice on the lake and the ducks are walking on top of it. So we had a little bit of depreciation. Some poets were staying home today and they're sick. But these are the brave poets who came out to show you how to wake up to your life. We all wrote poems. Many of us wrote especially for this occasion. I'm one of those who did. And we're going to share our poetry with you before we jump into the lake. And it's somehow written on our suits or our bodies. And it's certainly indelibly written in our minds. And hopefully yours too. Okay. That's nice. You came out of the twinkling sky. Once, long ago, the sky shattered. And it fell and fell and fell. It fell for a very long time. Years later, it began to impact a tiny planet below. When it did, it made a tinkle, twinkle, tin sound upon the ocean, then upon the lands. This was the origin of the tinkle, twinkle, tin sea and the tinkle, twinkle, tin forest. All the twinkling set the boats up. Woo-wee-woe-oh, into the thin white clouds, and back down again in dark green valleys of waves. When the seas began to settle, then came a light. First a blue haze, then a shock of yellow-blue, then white, everywhere white, thin hairs and thick carpets and glass tubes and round balls like a Christmas star up close and far away, white. And the little sailors, mostly women, in their little boats, mostly Bristol Channel cutters, began to harbor themselves and build wooden shapes in cozy harbors called home. In the very center of each home was a hearth, and from those sprung stories and poems and songs, one of which was you.